experts scrutinize long-term effects of mRNA COVID vaccines. The COVID-19 Delta variant forced nations to agree on booster shots. Israel was the first to do it among vulnerable populations. Then, the US FDA fully approved Pfizer's vaccine. So Israeli experts analyze mRNA COVID vaccines to know more. Keep watching to find out what they have learned so far. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. Before the pandemic, mRNA technology has been a part of studies to develop vaccines and treatments for other diseases. It is during COVID-19 that technology got launched officially. According to the Jerusalem Post, Tal Brosh at Samson Asuta Ashdod University Hospital said he can't be sure what will happen to someone who got an mRNA vaccine 10 years later. But there isn't enough evidence to suggest they will experience long-term bad outcomes either. There are two possible explanations for this. First, this is the first time mRNA was used to vaccinate millions of people. Experts have nothing else to compare Pfizer's and Moderna's COVID vaccines to. So, they will only rely on constant monitoring for years to know any long-term effects. Second, if there is a reaction, it should happen soon, like within 2 hours, several weeks, or a few months. Experts will have question marks on their heads if the immune system just decided to ping the body 10 to 15 years later. Michelle Linnell at the Hebrew University of Jerusalem understands why some feel nervous about booster shots. Since no one is sure what these new vaccines can do in the long run, a person is likely agitated over this and that. That's the reason why experts tell people to monitor themselves after vaccination. Get medical attention if something is amiss. But when a person gets a deep cut, a doctor will recommend a tetanus booster. More often than not, the patient is unlikely to ask if it is safe or will it affect their ability to have babies. For years, people have understood what tetanus shots are. For the sake of argument, FDA noted, information is not yet available about potential long-term health outcomes on Pfizer's vaccine. Also, a study published in the New England Journal of Medicine showed the rare myocarditis adverse effect, but at a low rate of 2.7 events per 100,000 persons. If you are unvaccinated, your risk of myocarditis is 4 times higher if you contract COVID-19. What do you think about mRNA vaccines? Do you believe this platform can unlock better treatments for other infectious diseases like HIV and tuberculosis? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.